Hey, this is Ryan Turek from Choice Cuts. I'm here at the Weekend of Horrors. Let's head into the dealer's room and talk with some of the guests. Standing here at the Weekend of Horrors with Lamberto Bava and the great Sergio Stivaletti. Lamberto, pleasure to meet you.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming. You are now hitting the convention circuit quite a bit. Do you like getting a lot of interaction one-on-one with your fans? More so now than ever, right?
I'm very glad to stay there, and it's very an emotion for me to see the fan coming. My fan of Demons. Demons is a movie 25 years ago.
Yeah, I know.
And 25 years is a generation.
It's a long time. Yeah,
it's a long time.
I have to ask. I asked Lamberto this, but you know, what do you think the drive is? I mean, you know, 25 years later, 20 years later, people are still coming back to these movies. Yeah. You know, I mean, they're kind of. I would say that they're not avoiding the contemporary cinema, but there is still a lifespan for these movies. What do you think is behind it? I mean, is it because they love the effects or because they love the story? What is it?
Well, I don't know exactly why, but when I see the film, when I see Demons, also to me, make a strange sense of something that I can't say what. I think that, like every film in the past, there is something coming from, I don't know, from the age, from the... And we did the effects, in some way that now is not common to see.
Well, the practical effects are almost, you know, computers have definitely taken over, yeah.
Yes, the effect is that when you... I am not fight against the digital. I like digital when it can help you in making a lot of things. Yeah. Also like effects, like makeup effects and everything, because you can cancel something, you can help the effect.
Yeah. I'm standing in front of the mighty Millennium Bug, right? This is the Millennium Bug from your film.
Yes, it is.
And you are?
Kenneth Cran, the writer, director, producer, special effects production designer.
There's no CGI, so your post must be absolutely easy, since you don't have to worry about any CGI effects.
No. Just because there's no CGI doesn't mean that there's no post. So yeah, we had a lot of compositing,
yeah.
a lot of intense sound design, but no CGI stuff. We knew what we were getting in the camera when we shot it. And that was what was so sweet about it.
Your directorial debut, Wax Mask. Obviously, there was a tremendous pressure on you, but what did you take out of the effects experience and working with some of the great directors you've worked with? How did you apply it to, you know, your own production?
Well, when you do special effects, you in your mind you are a little part of you is a director.
Yeah.
You are starting to think to the shooting. To how it's better to put something in front of camera, and you start a school like directing, you know.
Yeah.
And I was 40 years old when I made my first film, so it was a lot of experience before.
Yeah.
It was my first film, but it was seems to be, I don't know, the 100 films made before for me, and it was not difficult to go from the special effects to directing.
Yeah.
And the pressure came from the fact that the film was supposed to be done by Lucio Fulci, who was a so important director, and also Dario Argento, producer on my back, you know? So
that's a hell of a team right there. Talk about what the film is about.
The film takes place in 1999, if everybody remembers Y2K. We have our family escaping into the mountains to get away from the potential of Y2K, the potential, right? But what they find up there are some crazy inbred cannibal hillbillies, Okay, pretty standard stuff, but what nobody knows is that there is a monster under the forest floor, and that every 1,000 years it's coming up out of the ground to wreak havoc for about a day. Nice. It dies, lays its eggs, then we wait for another 1,000 years.
Nice. So it's a little bit of a genre mashup. I mean, it's you're getting your archetypal inbred hills have eyes kind of thing, and then you've got your full-on, I don't even know what to compare them, but a creature feature.
It's a creature feature, yeah. Hills Have Eyes meets Godzilla and Alien. So
the Millennium Bug is that big?
It is 30 feet tall.
Nice.
It's 30 feet tall.
Nice. Mm-hmm.
Now, I love my kind of man in suit type movies, so I'm presuming that's what you did here.
Absolutely. We actually we had the full size marionette, we call him. We hung him from chains on the studio roof.
Okay.
And then we also did the man in the suit, 1/6 scale, with cable controlled animatronics to make him a little bit more lifelike in the head.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Very much like.
What filmmakers today are inspiring you? What filmmakers are you, young filmmakers, are you seeing that you see promise in?
Well, I don't know. I don't see too many horror movies coming. I'm still, it's not a new director. I say that I take a lot of inspiration from my cult director, like Ridley Scott, for example.
Oh, yeah.
And also from special effects man making here in the United States, like, I don't know, K&B, and they do a lot. So I can't say not many names, but Rob Zombie is another.
Now, I'm seeing over here on the table pretty much which is the equivalent of fuck CGI. So what's your beef?
We don't mind good CGI, but right now, and I'm saying we as our production company, but we are really tired of the CGI look and aesthetic. You know, you can have a decent looking movie with a good story and good actors, but then the CGI effects come on and you're like, fuck it, why did I even bother?
What filmmakers are you seeing today that that you're particularly enjoying who are working in the field today?
I think Red Zombie.
Yeah.
Bob Zombie, yeah.
You heard it here. Lamberto Bava loves Rob Zombie. That's very controversial and awesome.